their livelihoods. Now, with the community assessment that I did before moving here, and arrangement with the barangay, especially San Chanco, Kanawa, Iligan City, through a memorandum of agreement to nurture or care my program, and with their needs also. Now, this is in partnership with the National Power Corporation Watershed Management Division, MSUIIT, and the Department of Psychology, as well as the National Women's Commission that I am a member of, and especially the Vagina Monologue Program. Through this assessment, they said that they needed innovative livelihood for economic resource and environmental awareness program. Since they are not already living in their original home, but in a renovation site that is established for them. Now, with that project, it focuses on vermicomposting, which basically means the management of worms, or a way of composting using earthworms to speed up the process. Because as we all know, worms are the soil scientists in the earth that we live in. Now, through vermicomposting, through research and consultation of my partner institutions, this is a use for fertilizer production, enhanced growth of plants, and provides a lot of prosperous and financially rewarding fertilizer. The objective of this project is that it would my project would install at most two or more vermi beds according to how much I would be able to service it. And with that, the outcome would be we would be able to produce organic fertilizer from biodegradable materials with earthworms, specifically African night crawlers. And in closing, I believe that we have to maximize environmental programs and introduce long-standing solution to the problem, and I've seen also in my city and in this particular community. And with that, I aim to empower and resilient Iligalon as well as these people who are displaced by Typhoon Sendong and either or Typhoon Fabio. That would be all. Because first and foremost, to engage them again to the environment and give them a form of livelihood that they can innovate from their relocation site.
We used that very compost to make something.
Different resources, like used vitamin. mainly through vegetables, you know, vegetables and other stuff. We can innovate and get something out of scraps.
And you learn anything from your visit to Golden Farm?
Yes, a lot.
And Arnold Farm?
Yes, sir.
So your emphasis is on sustainable agriculture.
What would be the center for your art collection and art?
fire.
That's right.
Probably in my hand, because we have a strong connection there.
Okay, there's only a connection going on. And then, so you think you can get the project done in 2 months?
Yes, ma'am.
You can get some crafts?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm sure that there's samples of crafts where, she will be there.
So what will the people do with the artwork that they produce? Will they be on exhibit, will they be sold, will they teach other people how to make artwork? So there will be livelihood opportunities?
It can be done in an exhibit, and we will invite people who are interested to buy it. Because the money that we will be able to raise, will be donated to our community partners to help them in their needs. Or probably, it can also be a form of lending, we will teach mothers who are staying.
It should be an ongoing thing. Can you scroll down, is there any more after that?
Is there scroll down, the end of?
Okay.
Anybody else?
Thank you.
So you should include what you discussed during the sessions, and also when the person asked you, I have the notes anyway.
Thank you. not that much, but then when I was, before I went here in the US, I have talked with my relatives about my own family. So there were some knowledge that I knew already.
Okay. So basically your project, you just bring people, specialists together, and then volunteers. And then in one afternoon, how much of a man for a
So idea for us to plant the propagules if
Sambagsa. Question for outgoing girl, for doing men girl. Okay. Do men girls really need a lot of help since they are always submerged under water? So they're always water? Find out, no? If, are they different from the regular trees? Like you have to water them and so every so often.
Yeah, how much care do you have?
Yeah, how much care do you need? Right.
And then the other thing with these projects is make sure that local community supports the project.
Yeah.
Not the city officials alone, it has to be the local partners that are going to take care, help take care of these neighborhoods.
It should be their project. That's the helpful tip number one. It's not the local government, it's not yours, it's a community's. They feel it's theirs and they really need it so that they will take care of what goes on there. Okay, tip number one, it's community.
Sounds like ownership.
Nay? Oxygen. Are you doing archaeology? Joking. Ask them to select a picture, their favorite picture in the US, on their cover page.
I mean, there's already the big one.
we found out it's a problem in some places. That's why, even no matter how many trash bins you put in this collection, yeah, that's why the solution we discussed was you have to talk to them. But Tita Lynn is a very good question. You have lecture on 3 hours, and there should be actual hands-on. Okay, so add one component. Okay, on that. Thank you. Sambak sa. Okay, next batch, Mr. Gordon. Because we're, he asked me, I said, we're okay with it. He said, oh my God, because he came to see us. Please proceed.